Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're going to be going over an effect that we pulled off in this video here. It's a classic quick change effect, and we're going to be going over how to film it and how to make it look like magic in After Effects. So let's get into it. This is a classic effect that you've probably seen pulled off in a variety of different ways over the years, but it really all comes down to a couple of key principles. Number one, lock off your shot on a tripod. Number two, keep your body oriented exactly the same way so as to make it easier to match up in post. And three, either distract with motion or completely cover whatever it's changing. Step one is pretty simple. Lock off your camera on a tripod. Make sure that you like the way that your subject looks and that nothing else in the shot is actually moving. And most importantly, make sure that the lighting isn't changing between your takes. Like at all. So shooting outside and shooting with a window as your source of light is probably a big no-no. Step two, now that you've actually locked off your shot and you like the way it looks, make sure you know what you want to change about your subject. This doesn't just have to be for clothing. It can be any visual element of your subject, even changing your subject entirely. Now you need to find a motion or an object that you can cover part of your subject with. You can go to the extreme and completely cover your subject with a blanket or another large object. But there are other ways that you can achieve the same result. In this video that we showed the effect with, I just used my hands to cross over my clothing. This worked because there was always a point where my body was covered from left to right, and you couldn't see behind my arms. Remember that the goal is to have three parts. One, a beginning where you start in one state. Two, a middle where you cross over between the two states. And three, an end where you actually reveal the change. But you don't even need to cover your subject with an object as long as you keep your body perfectly oriented between takes. As long as there's a motion to follow through from one state to the other, you can seamlessly cut between the two states. Now that you know the basic principle behind it, let's actually go over how you film this effect. Make sure that when you start filming, you start by doing the initial take before the change over and over and over again, making sure to follow through with the motion past where you'd actually make the change. The more times you do it, the more variations you'll have to be able to use in the editing room, and the more likely you'll have an option to be able to merge your clips seamlessly together with. Then, remembering the exact position that your body was in, change whatever element you want to appear different after the quick change. If it helps, keep your feet exactly where they are, or you could put tape down or another object to act as a marker. Make sure that you keep the camera rolling so that you don't jiggle it around by pressing the button to stop it. It can also really help to keep the items that you need to change into within reaching distance. The less you move, the less likely you'll mess up this effect. Now that you've changed your outfit or other elements, follow through on the same motion that you started with in the first take. The goal is that if you were to cut between them with no fancy editing, you'd be able to see it act as one complete piece of footage minus the change in outfit. Now that you've gotten all of your takes from before and after the change, bring them all into After Effects. This is where you take your footage from good to great. Look through all the takes that you did both at the beginning and the end. Your goal isn't necessarily to find your favorite takes of each, but which two takes match up as exactly close as possible. Once you find those two, line them up and cut them down so that they cut between one to the other as flawlessly as possible. What can really help is to overextend them over each other and then drop the opacity of the top clip so that you can see them both at the same time. Now, if you're using just a distracting motion, you can actually leave it as just a cut from one to the other, choosing the most violent point to make the cut. But if you have something covering up your subject, you're going to need to do some masking. Start with the top clip that comes first in sequence. And as you approach the point where you need to make the transition happen, mask around whatever is covering the frame. Make sure that as you're masking your subject, you include the background in the transition, so that during the course of the change, you actually go entirely from one clip to another. Also, do some tests to see if either adding the mask or subtracting the mask will give you a better result. Depending on how you shot your video and how exactly your body orientation was matched up between the two takes, one of these situations will end up playing out better than the other. But the key is you won't know until you try them both. Keyframe your mask to reveal the new subject as it wipes across and passes over different parts of your subject. The more motion your object has, the greater likelihood that you'll be able to feather your mask to cover up any unfortunate mistakes. And what you should be left with is an effect that basically makes it look like you're a magician. Because that's what editing is. It's magic. It's taking something and showing it to your audience that's absolutely not true. But it's so convincing that they have no choice but to believe it. But guys, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching. As always, we've got tons more tutorials here at motionarray.com. And for those of you here on YouTube, consider giving the video a like, subscribing, and even clicking the bell icon so that you never miss when we post. Thanks so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.